Good morning everyone and welcome to the class. Presently we are doing the chapter Crisis of Democratic Order, and under this chapter we have discussed the situation which was prevailing in the country after the fifth general election, and we have also seen the controversy between the judiciary on the one hand and the parliament and the executive on the other hand. Moreover, we have seen how this emergency was proclaimed on 25th June 1975, and then we have discussed the consequences also. And in the previous class we have discussed the controversies. The first controversy was there really requirement of proclamation of national emergency? क्या सही में नेशनल इमरजेंसी प्रोक्लेम करने की ज़रूरत थी? वॉट एवर सिचुएशन वॉज देयर, इट वॉज द आर्ग्यूमेंट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट दैट द गवर्नमेंट वॉज नॉट एबल टू फोकस ऑन इट्स डेवलपमेंटल प्रोग्राम्स. इट वॉज ओनली फोकसिंग ऑन मेंटेनिंग लॉ एंड ऑर्डर. बिकॉज ऑफ प्रोटेस्ट एंड एजिटेशन द लॉ एंड ऑर्डर सिचुएशन वॉज बिकम वेरी बैड, एंड द गवर्नमेंट वॉज नॉट एबल टू मेंटेन लॉ एंड ऑर्डर इन द कंट्री, एंड इन दैट सिचुएशन इट वॉज नॉट एबल टू इम्प्लीमेंट इट्स डेवलपमेंटल प्रोग्राम्स दैट वॉज एम्ड एट रिमूवल ऑफ पॉवर्टी. So this was the argument of the government, but against this argument, what argument is given by the opposition? That whatever protest and agitations were going on at that time in the country, these protests and agitations were totally non-violent, and at some places, to some extent, these agitations became violent, but. Even in that situation, the government has routine power to control such situation. There is no need of proclamation of emergency power. Government should have used its routine power. And it is also argued by the opposition that the leaders who were arrested by the government, they were not charged for they are causing any kind of threat to national security. There was no such charge on any of the arrested leaders. So this is baseless to say that the condition was such that the government was not able to focus on its functions. But actually, the government wanted to secure itself. The aim of the government was not to secure the country, because there was no threat to the security and unity of the country. There was threat to the ruling party. There was threat to the prime minister. So this emergency was proclaimed only to give them protection, only to secure the ruling party, only to secure the interest of the ruling party and the post of the prime minister. Okay? And the second controversy is regarding whatever happened during emergency. That was highly controversial. The government is of the view in this regard that it started its developmental programs like 20-point program, which was aimed at alleviation of poverty, and its main focus was the poor class. On which it was not able to focus because of agitation and protest which was prevailing there before the proclamation of emergency. So it was the argument of the government that it started its developmental program. And we also find that the urban middle class was supporting the government, because they were also very upset with these protests and agitation, and they felt that by this proclamation of national emergency, now there will be peace and development. So this was the response of urban middle class. Then the poor class, the rural poor class was also with the government. But what happened during emergency, we have seen the preventive detention was used extensively. People were arrested custodial deaths were frequent. So many people were disappeared. Not only this, the newspaper were not free. Censorship was there. So all these then displacement of people, especially in Delhi, and compulsory sterilization was done. So all these things were not needed by the government. If it wanted to focus on developmental programs, then these things were not needed. But the government did this, and the purpose was to target the opposition. So this was the main controversy regarding this proclamation of emergency. And now we will see that this emergency, which was there for around 1.5 years, for 18 months, this emergency, this national emergency was there in the country. We see that this emergency brought out both the weakness and the strength of India's democracy. Both the things at the same time. How it it is bringing out the weakness? Because we came to know that our structure, our framework, which is given by the constitution, is not so strong that no one can subvert it. It can be subverted by the government using constitutional methods only. The government, whatever was done by the government, nothing was unconstitutional. Everything was done according to the constitution. It took advantage of the loopholes of the constitution. So this was the weakness which came out, ki jo hamara democracy hai wo khatam ho gaya. Is sabse badi weakness to yahi hai ki if the situation is such that undemocratic order is was there for 18 months, that was the end of democracy. This is the most important weakness of our system. But at the same time, what we find that this emergency was not a permanent feature. That was only for a short duration of time. That was only for 18 months. And after 18 months, what we find that democracy was restored. So this is also showing the strength of democracy. Ki hum democracy ko humare yahan nahi rahi. Ded saal tak democracy nahi thi. That was totally undemocratic route. Lekin after 1.5 years, that democracy was restored. This is the strength. We can't live without democracy. Ultimately, democracy ko aana hi padega. So this is the strength. So we experienced both the things at the same time. And we have also experienced that in our constitution, there are some loopholes. There are some ambiguity. There is lack of clarity in the constitution. And any government can take advantage of these loopholes. Any government can take advantage of these ambiguity. And it was done by the Congress government under the Prime Ministership of Indira Gandhi. This was done by them. So now the focus was कि जो भी loopholes हैं, जो भी ambiguity है, उसको खत्म किया जाए, to end this ambiguity. And for that reason, some changes were done in our constitution. Like now, it was written in the constitution. The constitution was amended for that purpose, that the president can proclaim emergency only on the written recommendation of the cabinet. As we have seen how emergency was proclaimed in the country on the night of 25th June 1975, that the Prime Minister has given a recommendation. No cabinet meeting was there. It was only the recommendation of the Prime Minister. And the President acted on the recommendation of the Prime Minister, and emergency was proclaimed. So now this was made clear in the constitution, that if such type of recommendation is coming from the government, then it should be written, and this recommendation should be come from Council of Ministers, not from only from the Prime Minister. This is a very important change in the Constitution, because it is this kind of provisions are there in order to stop the dictatorship. जो डिक्टेटरशिप हमने 1.5 साल देखा, उसको हम आगे फिर से उस तरह के कंडीशन नहीं आए, उसके लिए ये प्रोविजन किया गया. देन नेक्स्ट द दैट इज ऑल्सो मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट चेंज इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, दैट अर्लियर देर वॉज प्रोविजन इन द आर्टिकल 352 दैट द इमरजेंसी, नेशनल इमरजेंसी कैन बी प्रोक्लेम्ड ऑन टू रीजंस, ऑन टू ग्राउंड्स, एक्सटर्नल एग्रेशन एंड इंटरनल डिस्टर्बेंस. Okay, so external aggression and internal disturbance. So these are the two grounds on which national emergency can be proclaimed. Now, the government at that time in 1975, the government misused this internal disturbance because it is highly ambiguous. Which situation will you call internal disturbance? इसके बारे में कोई भी clarity नहीं है constitution में कि किस condition को हम कहेंगे कि internal disturbance create हो गया है and now we need to proclaim national emergency. It was not clear. So now what was done, that instead of this, a new term was added in Article 352, and that is armed rebellion. So now what we find is that there can be national emergency on two grounds only. The first is external aggression, whenever some external power has attacked our country, then in that case, national emergency can be proclaimed. And the second is, this criteria has been added. Now the second criteria is armed rebellion. जब कि internal देश के अंदर में armed rebellion हो रहा है, मतलब it is with the use of force and violence rebellion is done against the government. Then in that situation only national emergency can be proclaimed. So what was the situation at that time? The situation which was prevailing at that time, that was not armed rebellion. That was only a kind of, we can say, unrest. क्योंकि बहुत ज़्यादा level पे, बहुत ज़्यादा degree पे protest हो रहे हैं. तो that was only a situation of unrest. और अगर opposition के demands को मान लिया जाता तो वो सारे protest खत्म हो जाते. नहीं भी मान करके अगर गवर्नमेंट अपने थोड़े स्ट्रिक्ट एक्शंस लेकर के उसको चाहती तो वो दबा सकती थी, बट इट मिसयूज्ड इट्स पावर, है ना. और इंटरनल डिस्टरबेंस जो टर्म था उसको मिसयूज करके इमरजेंसी प्रोक्लेम किया गया. सो इट नाउ इट हैज बीन चेंज्ड टू आर्म्ड रेबेलियन. सो दीज आर द टू मेजर चेंजेस विच हैव बीन अकर्ड इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. कि एक तो कैबिनेट की रिटर्न रिकमेंडेशन पे ही प्रेसिडेंट प्रोक्लेम करेंगे इमरजेंसी, और दूसरी ये कि इंटरनल डिस्टरबेंस की जगह आर्म्ड रेबेलियन आ गया है. ओके, तो अब जो एम्बिग्यूटी थी वो खत्म हो गई. ओके, उसके बाद और भी हमने बहुत कुछ लेसन सीखा. जो थर्ड लेसन है वो ये है कि जैसे ड्यूरिंग द इमरजेंसी व्हाट वी फाउंड, दैट सिविल लिबर्टीज वर अटैक्ड, पीपल लॉस्ट देयर राइट टू लाइफ, राइट टू लिबर्टी. People lost their right to constitutional remedy. They were not given constitutional remedy by the courts. The courts were not allowed to issue these habeas corpus writ. So what was the condition? The condition was that there was lack of civil liberty. So we learned a lesson from this. So people became aware of the value of civil liberties. We were given civil liberties by our constitution as fundamental rights, and jo cheeze bahut aasani se to nahi mili. For that, in order to get those fundamental rights, we have fought a long battle against the British rule, against the colonial rule, still people were not aware of the value of civil liberties. क्या होती है इसकी, किसी चीज़ की value हमें तभी पता चलती है जब वो चीज़ हमसे छीनती है, जब वो चीज़ हमारे पास नहीं होती है. द सेम प्रिंसिपल वॉज देयर ऑल्सो. जब ड्यूरिंग इमरजेंसी वेन पीपल वर डिप्राइव्ड ऑफ देयर सिविल लिबर्टीज, देन दे अंडरस्टूड इट्स वैल्यू. हाउ इम्पॉर्टेंट इज इट, इसका क्या इम्पोर्टेंस है, वो तब उनकी समझ में आया. और देन वी सी दैट सो मैनी सिविल लिबर्टी ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस केम इन टू एग्जिस्टेंस बिकॉज नाउ पीपल आर अवेयर, दे आर मेकिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस की हमारे राइट्स हमारे लिए बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है एंड नो वन शुड स्नैच दिस राइट फ्रॉम अस. तो दिस काइंड ऑफ अवेयरनेस इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट इफ वी वॉन्ट दैट द डेमोक्रेसी शुड बी स्ट्रांग, इफ वी वॉन्ट दैट डेमोक्रेसी शुड बी मीनिंगफुल, देन दिस अवेयरनेस इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट. विदाउट दिस अवेयरनेस देयर कैन नॉट बी रियल डेमोक्रेसी, क्योंकि अवेयरनेस ही हमारे लिए जरूरी है. जब हम अवेयर होंगे तभी हमारे राइट्स हमसे नहीं छीने जाएंगे. इफ वी आर नॉट अवेयर देन एनी वन कैन स्नैच राइट्स फ्रॉम अस. सो पीपल बिकम अवेयर एंड दे मेड सो मेनी सिविल लिबर्टी ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोटेक्ट द लिबर्टीज ऑफ द पीपल. नॉट ओनली दिस, वी ऑल्सो फाइंड दैट द judiciary also became active in protecting the civil liberties of the people, because we have seen that during emergency the role of judiciary has also become controversial, because the constitutional bench of the Supreme Court delivered the judgment that during emergency there cannot be this right to constitutional remedy does not exist. So this because of this we find that after the emergency, after the end of emergency, the judiciary also became active in protecting the civil liberties of the people. So this was the third lesson, and now we will see that so many new lessons we have learned by this emergency. Now this has also become a point of debate that what should be the extent of protest of the people. In a democracy we have the right to protest, but because of these protests what happened that there was end of democracy. The end was temporary, but still that 1.5 year was very difficult years, and so many people were disappeared, so many people faced the consequences which have impacted their life for forever. तो अब ये समझ में आ रहा है कि these are the debates कि अगर हमें right to protest है democracy के अंदर तो कहाँ तक है, कितना है, क्या हमें protest का अधिकार नहीं है. So this became a point of controversy and debate. Not only this, what we find that the government has proclaimed emergency. That's okay. Now, the order of the government is to be implemented by whom? The order of the government is to be implemented by the administration and the police, because the government is not there to implement the orders. The government is there only to make orders, only to make decisions. These decisions, these orders are implemented through administrations and police. So these institutions actually they become instrument of the government. They were not acting independently. It is expected, it is the duty of the administrator and the policeman to work independently. They are not to work as the agent of the government or the instrument of the government. But during emergency what we find that there was lot of political pressure upon the administration and police, and all these institutions they started to work as the instrument of the government. This was found by Shah Commission also. So what we find that even today, the character of our administration and police has the same. They are not independent. They act according to the ruling party, whoever party, jis party ki bhi sarkar, they act according to that government. So this is the, we can say it's a trend. It has started from then only. Okay, now we have completed this lessons. These are the lessons, these are the debates, and now we will see politics after emergency. What was the politics? How was the politics after emergency? So what we find that the emergency was over in 18 months. It was the emergency was ended in January 1977. And after emergency, after the end of emergency, there was effort to restore the democracy, because within 2 months, in March 1977, we see that elections were held. Okay, and this election of March 1977, it was actually turned out to be a referendum on the experience of the emergency. What does it mean? It turned out to a referendum on the experience of the emergency. Whatever people experienced during emergency, they voted according to that experience. And what we find that the badly affected region of this emergency was the northern part of the country. In North India, the impact or consequences of emergency was very hard. People suffered a lot because of this emergency in North India. And we find that people voted according to this experience. Because when we see the result, we see that in North India, the Congress was defeated badly, because there was the very bad impact of emergency. People suffered very badly during emergency, and that is why they did not vote for Congress, and it defeated very badly. But if we see in the southern part or the western part, we see that the defeat of Congress was not so bad, because there these were the reasons where consequences were also not very bad. So in this way we can say that this election of March 1977 was a referendum on the experience of emergency. And the opposition, the main issue of opposition was save democracy. Because whatever was the situation in the country was against democracy. Democracy was ended for 1.5 years. So now the opposition was there only to save democracy. It is giving the message to the people that the government which ended democracy temporarily, he say, but jisne end kar diya democracy ko, we will, you should not give your valuable vote to that party. If you want to save democracy, you should give your vote to the opposition parties. Okay, and we can say that actually this emergency period, actually this the experience of this emergency period has strengthened up the foundation of democracy in India. How can you say that this emergency the national emergency, which was there for 18 months, has actually strengthened the foundation of democracy. Because we see that whatever was the result of the election, which happened after the end of emergency, the results proved that people are not going to support that government which is anti-democratic. If you are going to be anti-democratic, then you are not going to get the vote of the people. So, agar aap anti-democratic hain, to it can be only for 5 years, not more than that, because after that you will have to face elections, and when elections will be there, you will be voted out. So, in this way, the government, the political parties, they understood the demand of the people. Democracy was the first and foremost demand. Okay, so in this way we can say that this whatever we experienced during emergency, actually that strengthened the foundation of democracy. Though it seems ki us samay, it seems nahi, actually that was the end of democratic rule for the 1.5 years, lekin iske jo consequence hue wo consequence sahi the, अच्छे थे, उसने हमारे डेमोक्रेसी को और भी स्ट्रॉन्ग बनाया. ओके, सो नाउ वी विल सी द इलेक्शन ऑफ 1977. इन द इलेक्शन ऑफ 1977 व्हाट हैपेंड दैट दिस इमरजेंसी वाज एंडेड इन जनवरी एंड द गवर्नमेंट ऑर्डर्ड फॉर न्यू इलेक्शन इन मार्च 1977. एंड व्हेन there was decision to hold elections, then the political leaders who were arrested during emergency, they all were released, all the leaders and activists and workers of the political parties, they were released from jails. And now the opposition party was not having much time. They were having only 2 months time to prepare for the election, but they acted very rapidly. And we see that what happened, that even before emergency, we have seen that when Jayaprakash Narayan was organizing protest and rallies and all these things were done in the leadership of Jayaprakash Narayan, at that time also we have seen that the opposition parties started to come together. They were projecting Jayaprakash Narayan as the alternate to the Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. So this started to take place even before the emergency, and after the end of emergency we find that all the opposition parties, they formed a new party, and this was party was known as Janata Party. The name itself says Janata Party. Kiski party? Janata ki party. Matlab democratic. So the name itself carries a message. Okay. So we see that this Janata Party, and who was the leader of this Janata Party? The leader was JP, Jayaprakash Narayan. Okay. And we see that some other Congress leaders also came out and formed a separate party, and that was under the leadership of Jagjivan Ram. And this the name of this party was Congress for Democracy. So this party, Congress for Democracy. This was the party which came out from the original Congress party, and the leader of this Congress for Democracy, the leader of this party was Jagjivan Ram. But later, what we find that this party, Congress for Democracy, it also merged with the Janata Party. Because of the situation, all the opposition parties were under this Janata Party. And we see that Janata Party, it made this election like a referendum. अगर आप कांग्रेस को भी वोट दे रहे हैं तो यू आर सपोर्टिंग इट्स एक्ट ऑफ वॉट एवर इट डिड ड्यूरिंग इमरजेंसी एंड इफ यू आर नॉट गिविंग योर वोट टू कांग्रेस एंड यू आर गिविंग योर वोट टू जनता पार्टी देन इट इज़ फॉर डेमोक्रेसी सो दिस टाइप ऑफ सिचुएशन वॉज प्रिवेलिंग एट दैट टाइम एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन रिगार्डिंग दिस in the next class.